I am regimental, meticulous, and I'm brave. Women are great multitaskers, and women are powerful. Hi, I'm Mithali Raj, captain Indian women's cricket team. Cricket happened to me. I guess I was destined to play this sport. I've learned Bharatanatyam, classical Bharatanatyam, for a good 8 years, and cricket happened after that because dad was in Air Force and he wanted to sort of inculcate the habit of early rising, and hence he put me into sport. And this sport was also, my brother was in cricket and I used to tag along with him to the ground. That's how I was introduced to the sport. And way back in the 90s, not everybody were aware of women's cricket in our country. So it was a little difficult to find a role model in terms of a woman cricketer. But growing up, I've always looked up to men cricketers because they were quite often on the television playing cricket. So I think that's how I got into sport. And professionally, at the age of 10, I started playing under 16 and under 19 for the state. I would definitely pursue the Bharatanatyam, and I would have been a classical dancer if not for cricketer, because I had to discontinue dance just 2 stages before the Arangetam, that is the stage performance that you do. Our thought process, especially in our society way back in the 90s, was very conventional in terms of women, getting into sport was something everybody looked down on. And coming from a South Indian Tamil family, it was more so because my grandparents didn't wanted me to pursue a sport, which was so rough. And they would always sort of, taunt my parents saying that she's a girl and why did you put her into a sport where there are, more chances of getting injured or probably gets few cuts on the face. Eventually, she has to get married. So these were the things that, my parents had to face at home. But when it came to society or people, I think more often people would ask us, is it a hockey team rather than, it could also be a cricket team. So they would take it by a surprise when they get to know that, I'm a cricketer and I'm pursuing the sport professionally. So they would they would throw a few questions like, do you play with tennis ball? Because girls get hurt and you're not too, it's a hard ball. Cricket is a hard sport and you girls might get injured, or is the boundary smaller? So these were the questions thrown at us, maybe because of ignorance, but that's how they looked at women playing cricket way back. But I think things have definitely improved over the years. When BCCI took over women's cricket in our country in 2006-07, I think a lot of things have changed for women cricketers. So coming under BCCI, the sort of resources that we were access to was amazing. Like, we got to access to National Cricket Academy. If the players are injured, they are taught how to sort of prevent injuries. And how the rehab takes place. So you have a setup there in National Cricket Academy where even men cricketers go. So that was access that started to be access to us, and we started to play matches in stadiums. Earlier, in early 2000, I remember playing few games in some park or in a school ground. But now we play all our domestic games also in the stadiums. And the biggest change has been contract system. All of us are contracted, so that really takes care of the financial part of a woman cricketer. If she aspires to play for country, she knows that now she can actually give more time to her profession rather than think how she can support her family or what next if she's not able to earn through this profession, which was a big hindrance before BCCI took over women's cricket. I read those comments like women's cricket is boring, they can't really hit too many sixes in an inning, so hardly there are any sixes, the score is just 230 or 250. So these it seems like, the criticism is more at the gender rather than the sport. So I think that is something is a little unfair, I would say, because women cricketers also equally put in the sort of hard work that any cricketer would do to play at that level, at the highest level. So the commitment is there, the sincerity is there. So why people criticize the gender rather than, we are open to constructive criticism when it comes to the sport or the skill. The current generation has everything, a lot of things, the resources are at their fingertips. So they get straight away, they get access to good facilities. But social media is something, if it is not probably handled well, can be taxing on young minds. And when you have a very young talented players or sports people, it's important they're mentored well. It's never easy to stand up for what you think is right. There are so many people who will stand against you, but it's easy to give up then and follow how you get influenced wrongly. But it takes a lot of courage to stand alone. I think for me, that is empowerment. And if you're a woman, stand up for your dreams, stand up for what you believe in. And that is women empowerment for me.